Hello and welcome to this series where I show and explain how a violin is built. In today's video we have a lot to do. As you remembered from the last episode, I glued the neck on the body without the back. My own way, it's a bit a trial. My own way to do it, normally we do it in another way. Anyway, if you want to know more, have a look to the previous video. Today, practically I'm going to glue the back on its place. But I have to do several things before I can do that. I have to finish the neck so that the back can go over it. I have to remove the mold, of course. Finish the linings, finish the blocks. Make the hole for the end pin at the underside. Put the label. Work also a bit on the back. A lot to do, as you understand, so let's start immediately. The first thing that I will do is finish this part. Now it is coming a bit out. It's like less than half a centimeter too long. I'm going to use my planes to lower it almost until the same height of the block. And then I will use the sandpaper, the big table I will show you, to finish it. Now that it is almost there, I'm going to use the big sandpaper table to finish it up and make it a nice straight line with the ribs and the blocks. I have put a piece of paper here to protect this part of the instrument that I don't want to change anymore. Now I remove the paper and give it just a very small cleanup. Just like that. Okay, now it's perfectly flat and we can go ahead. Now that this part is ready, I could remove the mold, but I'm not going to do that. Firstly, I'm going to reposition the back on its place using the nail at the underside and markings on the corners. And I will drill again the nail at the upper side, which got lost as this part of the neck went into the block. In this way, when the mold is gone, the neck will remain at its correct position and the projection of the fingerboard won't go too high or too low towards the bridge. And so the back has again its fixed position and I can remove the mold without being afraid to move the neck up and down too much. To remove the mold, I have to break these small joints that I had made between the blocks and the mold. I'm going to use a hammer and a small piece of wood. It is very tricky, I have to be very careful as I don't want to break anything else. Let's see how it goes. There are a couple that don't want to come. Let's try this way. That's good. And the last one is this one. There we go, and everything is still in one piece, good to see. That means that we can go ahead with the next step. Now I have to put the linings on the upper side of the ribs. I have done this also in the past. One of the first videos is about the linings. So I'm not going to show everything. I'm going to do it a bit faster. If you want to see, if you don't remember how that went, have a look to the video. I will put a link here. And now I can trim the linings, the part that comes over the ribs, and also the inner part. The linings are finished and trimmed. Now I have to trim the blocks a little bit, and I have to be very careful in doing this, as I might hit with a chisel the top, and as you know, the top is not a very hard kind of wood, so it might break. So I will do it slowly, slowly and very carefully. The blocks are also trimmed. Now I can give the inner part a good clean up. I will use some sandpaper. The inner part is ready. There is one last thing that I have to do, and that is to drill the hole for the end pin. This part of the instrument is ready. I can put it aside, and now I can go back to the back and do a couple of things, and that is clean the surface and break the corners and glue the label on its place. I will start with the corners with a file and another one. The back is ready and clean. Now I have to do the final thing. Put the label on its place. Now that the label is dry, I will also put my sign on it. And now it can go on its place. That's it for today's video. The violin is definitely getting shape. Thank you very much for watching. Many thanks also to the Patreons for supporting my channel. Don't forget to visit my Patreon page if you appreciate my content and would also like to support this channel. The link is in the description as always. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!